Okay, so something I don't understand is the delay with sometimes streamer mode being like on Discord being toggled. So like sometimes I have to exit streamer mode in order for it to like register my status on Discord, if you know what I mean. Oh yeah, I need to check my saves as well, which is somewhat important. Like I don't want to load a save and then, well, turns out I haven't saved and then I just lose the quick save. I always recommend doing that, by the way, in a game with like multiple saves. Okay, I can probably afford to do it. This is in Pentelus, but I just teleport to Origin and we're good. Now the thing is I want to test the fight probably on each difficulty for I don't know if I want to say consistency, but it seems like it's pretty important. Well, first of all, let's go to Origin before I do anything. Okay, I wanted to avoid getting spotted there, and I did.
It's good to keep a record.
Okay, I'm assuming what I could maybe do is just use the setup I use for Z. The annoying thing is, I have to toggle back to the whatever setup I'm on for Y, because Y is like a gatekeeper for Z, so. Yeah, this probably is just gonna be fine. I'm more interested on how this is gonna work for normal or hard, specifically. Sure enough, you can YOLO it. Yeah, hard might be a little weird, but it shouldn't be that weird, if you know what I mean. Like, to where I needed, like, to do an alternative strategy or something. What do you mean this? Oh. Oh, right, I didn't make the thing. Perhaps I'll save after I try the build. Or not, after I equip the build, rather. Not Tyon, am I? Oh, it looked like I was Tyon. Oh, hey. The mongoose. Oh yeah, so this fight, I could have just YOLO'd it the other day. But I was afraid to. And that makes me kind of disappointed. Question is, can I YOLO it for normal and hard? Or could I have YOLO'd it? For, I don't know. You get my point. Like, these things just melt, because I don't know how much HP they have, but... yeah, hard might be weird. Oh, nice. Honestly, that's fine. That was slower, but that might have been slower because it was, normal. Yeah, this is probably fine. If I'm really concerned, I walk in with Senna. But it shouldn't be that bad. Oh yeah, I'm debating, like, do I use, like, stories, because, like, on Twitch? Because, like, I feel like, on one hand, they're, like, that's a cool idea, but on the other hand, it's, like, I mean, what could they be useful for? Ooh, I haven't seen this art yet. Because... I think somebody unfollowed because, like, they looked at the story, then checked out my channel, and I'm like, oh, I haven't watched him in a while. Let's just unfollow. But yeah, I'm not going to let that probably discourage me, so. Okay, all I do here is change it to hard. I'm aware I could fight Y on hard, but that wouldn't give me much info. Because I would rather start from D and J, too, if I'm going to practice hard. Okay, I think I just walk in with Senna no matter what, because that seemed very obviously faster, right? Yeah, that seemed very fast compared to, you know. Oh, I'm gonna touch a save point here. Yeah, I don't think I need to practice anymore, because I think I get the idea. You just use Senna and then go to town with whoever you're using. Let's change it back to easy.
I'll hit him, and then I'm gonna hit him again.
Good thing we found this. Yep, that didn't take too long of testing, actually. Now that I think about it. Yeah, because, like, I could have just YOLO'd it, even on easy. On the hard, I probably need to do the, strategy with Senna, so...
A little break might be good right about now.
Don't stray from your path. That's what I'm here for.
Okay, now let's save it. Past that point. That took a while for those to pop up.
It's good to keep a record.
Now let's go back to title. I wish you could load the save without having to go back to the title screen. It's kind of something I dislike. I'm sending a message really fast. From, I don't even know how to word this message I'm typing up. It's really weird. Oh, continuing. Yeah. It's in a server. No, it's not in a server, but it's. I just loaded the same save again because I wasn't even looking at the screen. I love it. Honestly, that's fine. But yeah, it was in the X server. Where was that? Oh, I think I know where that thing was used at. Because I noticed they had 98 out of 99, and I think you do use one of them during the story. Actually, you use two of them technically, but you get one. So. Now, I'm not going to be dumb. Yeah, I think I want to do Gauntlet. Over, Time Attack. At least just today. I'm gonna change it to normal. Or, not normal. It's already on normal. But to easy. Because I don't like entering Time Attack or Gauntlet when it's on a different difficulty. It's just like a weird OCD thing. And yeah, I do also want to upgrade an accessory that I made, I think. Was it the most recent one I made? Yeah, it's this. I think it'd be pretty good. I don't want to use that, thank you. Because it would be next to useless for what we have set up. Or right now. Sure.
Leave it to me.
Oh yeah, so I want to talk about that new game plus the level down playthrough. So, I think it's gonna. Well, I don't know if I want to start it in chapter one. Is the thing, because the upgraded weapon. Well, if I'm afraid of the upgraded weapons, I just don't use the default classes. Right? So, like, I would change them out of that. And then, I guess, maybe even, like, the fusion arts, too, is something that bugs me. Because I want to sort of mimic a new game run, but not completely. Because, well, one, it's going to be controlling Uni for like 90% of it, so. Or Tion if I interlink. Or do a chain attack. Because technically, if I interlink as Uni and then do like level 3 or a Boros order, then yeah. Do I want to do normal? Not really. Oh, I thought I was gonna get another rank, but from this, but no, at stage 50. I'd rather go for consistent clears over, iffy clears. Because I can do easy very consistently. Even if it's kind of a trash run. Yeah, see, I already feel complied to, or compelled to go pretty far because we got Masha on the first pick. I would rather Alexandria here. I'm wearing Ashura as Khaleesi, but I want the attacker role first before I do anything. Because I do need the Khaleesi, members as well, but yeah, not every run is perfect for your team setup and your shop emblem setup as well. Hey, Cam. So, with the center defense team, I already got it done with, and I just said, okay, I could have fucking YOLO'd it, literally, on the run on, well, last stream, actually. So, on easy, it seems like I don't need a buff. But on normal and hard, it seems like I need to open up with Senna, and then I can just Elemental Genesis. But yeah, it seems very straightforward. So I will be doing it in the next run, whenever that is. I can say the next run is not this weekend. Because, no, I don't want to do, like, constant speed runs unless, like, oh, the run died and I want to run it back, for example. Also, I talked about doing this on normal here, but I didn't really want to do it. But I feel like I should aim to try it on normal. Also, I want to try the Full Metal Jaguar setup on this, but a little anxious about trying it because I don't know how much different the setup is. Like, isn't it just about agility? Because that's a little scary if it's just about agility. And yeah, I was a little salty about not getting Riku and Minana there, but whatever. Nah, we'll wait on that. That was a miss. I swear this is gonna turn out to be my most used art in this game. Like, Raging Force. Yeah, like, the Raging Force and, Elemental Genesis, I use a ton. I guess Glittering Melody as well, but not that often. And I'm of course excluding Lucky 7 because it's a signature move. I mean, technically they're all signature moves, but like Lucky 7 is a signature move. So it's excluded, in my opinion. Because when do you never like Or when do you not use Lucky 7 is the question. When it's like available to you. That's a very good question, I think. Like if you want to do air slash smash strats. Or if drawing Lucky 7 not like immediately is a bad idea. Yeah. Oh, did you mean were you if it was if you were okay with me creating it. Okay. I thought it was Like, did it work? But yeah, that's fine. Like, I don't care if people make threads as long as it's not, like, pointless. Because in other servers, they had to have disabled threads for, like, only moderators, and that's for, like, a good reason. If Lucky 7 is so good, why isn't there a Lucky 8? The Lucky 8 would be in Skyrim, because, well, they outlawed Talos. And it's the 8 Divines. Get it? That's a bad joke. Like, it could have been funnier. Like, especially if you don't get Skyrim. But yeah. Because it used to be the 9, and now it's just the 8. I should play Skyrim again on stream, but I don't know what to do exactly. Because I do want to get into Skyrim speedrunning, but I'm a little overwhelmed by it. Because Skyrim is a game I've played for, like, 12 years. Well, not on and off, but, or not consistently, but yeah. Honestly, it's really fun on, like, the latest, like, consoles, because, like, you have the Anniversary Edition. And I really like the original, like, DLC and stuff as well, because Dawnguard and Dragonborn is just really cool. Even if some people say it sucks, like, it's still cool. Like, especially when they add, like, a whole another map. Like, just, like, in, like, whenever, like, they add, like, a completely different map after it's only been, like, one world in a game, like, whether it's, like, Scarlet Violet or, you know, I know it's, like, bad comparisons, but I always think that's cool. Yeah, honestly, if I play 2 again, I might, like, well, I don't want to say I will, but, like, I might just, like, pull up the speedrun notes and, like, yellow it. The thing is, I wouldn't have Talos. And I don't know if Talos is, like, very, necessary for runs. Because I would prefer to keep this other save I have for, running back New Game Plus. Whenever that would be. Which, I don't know when it will be, but I do want to have that set on the table. Because, like, I'm not, like, giving up on, if you know what I mean. I thought I was gonna die there. I was gonna be really upset. How have I not gotten another hero? That's really surprising. I also want to do cutscene percent for this game. Part of me wants to just do cutscene percent for New Game Plus, but yeah. Guess who has the game now and just finished these? Ooh! You, I assume. But yeah, the Incursor Ascension quest is really cool, in my opinion, because, well, this is a minor spoiler, but you technically don't kill Mobius Q in Valdi's hero quest. And so, he comes back in the Incursor Ascension quest for revenge, and I think that's kind of cool. They should have done that for Valdi's Ascension quest, though, in my opinion. It would have been a little more fitting, but yeah. Oh yeah, cutscene percent. Yeah, honestly, it's really weird. Like, oh yeah, I'm gonna home button here, actually, and show you. Like, what would you apply a cutscene to be, specifically? Like, oh, is it only voice text? So this wouldn't be like a cutscene, right? Since they're not talking. Okay, so running without Talos is not as bad as I originally thought then. Because I know like some people have pulled Talos in runs, but I wasn't sure how useful she would be. Because the thing is, you can pull like Zenobia or something as well. As like an alternative. I might just... I want to abandon and do this on normal, but... You know what? The whimsy is delaying me abandoning this. I'm gonna abandon this, though, and do normal. In before the run is complete trash. Should I YOLO the normal mode run? Okay. Yeah, because I sort of want to just try to claim the normal mode gauntlet record right now, but if my run is trash, or like if I die, I'm going to be really upset. Do I have any... Oh, that's a lot more than I thought I had. Oh, wait, I'm looking at the red gems. I thought this was the blue gems. Oh. Oh, yeah. Like, Cam's talking about two, and... Honestly, what I thought about doing with two is next time I play it, I just... YOLO... probably any percent easy DLC, but I honestly want to do... New Game Plus of 2, because I attempted it and I didn't finish it. Back in, I don't think it was last year, it was like 2 years ago. But yeah, let me get a timer. Really fast. I'm not going to use, like, actual splits on this. But easy is slightly different. Okay. I mean, is easy faster? I'm aware it's, like, different, but yeah. I'm just going to use a generic timer for this. Let me also edit stream title since we've already messed with the center defense team. Time attack. Let's include Archsage Gauntlet, because... In the title, because... Gauntlet can mean two things in this game. One is this, the other is the Gauntlet in Chapter 5. Yeah, don't replace Overfall, because Full Metal Jaguar is a Aether Attack setup, and that's a pretty good art. But if you are being serious about it, I would look at, like, I don't know, maybe Wide Slash or something, like, if you want a second, like, evasion art. Because you already have, Quick Draw. Yeah. So, like, if you want, like, on a, like, a different art, so, like, get, like, Wide Slash or... Aerial Slash, like, just so you have, like, two, like, evasion arts. Overfall is good because it helps boost the overall damage if you get the Aether, defense down debuff. I was trying to figure out what the debuff is called, but yeah. Ah, okay. Yeah, if somebody else already has Overfall... You could just take it off, but, I mean, it doesn't hurt to keep it on there, if you know what I mean. Yeah, chat, I'm just gonna probably YOLO the normal mode run. And we'll see how it goes. I'm gonna feel really bad if I don't get Masha. Yeah, the debuff is like a write-off, especially with like a lot of things. Because you don't... Well, some bosses just are straight up immune to it, like... For example, N? I don't think you can lower his Aether defense. Well, it might be one of the two, Aether or Physical, but yeah. Okay, so we're gonna YOLO the normal mode run. I don't know if I'm gonna finish this, but we'll go as far as I can. I'm gonna try to ignore the timer as well. Yeah, that's what I thought. Does Machine Assassin use... It's Kevet. Well, actually... Yeah, it's a Kevesi class. Reason why I gave up on that. You know why? Pentelus region. Oh yeah, I saw that. And yet, for this gauntlet mode specifically, you want to avoid the Pentelus region. And maybe Cadencia. So you want to do this in Aetia or Fornus, ideally. Choose whichever challenge tickles friends fancy. Pentelus mainly to avoid the long loads. Cadencia, because of Erythia's Sea, can, like, move you underwater, and then you have to raise back up before the stage ends. Just kind of annoying. Cannot wait to see how friends tackle this one. Oh, I started the timer way too early. Technically, you could start there, but that's not what the rules say. Don't be Pentelus again, please. Challenge! Is there, like, a better way? Do I have to completely abandon this? Okay, no. I'll stick with Cadencia. Alright, that was a little late, but that's fine. Ah, okay. You know what? It'll be my pleasure. I know Rex is somebody we don't want to use, but I don't think I care too much. Pharaoh, unit number 7. I'll settle with Sigiri. Oh, damn. 50 minutes? That's insane. I remember it took me 2 hours to, kill the final boss of X with just one art. And, like, no attack stat. It was pretty nuts. Yeah, I don't know what I do if I don't get Masha. Like, do I settle with Isser? Or what? Or do I just go all attackers? Or just some random healer? Actually, how good is Isser as, like, healing, specifically? I'm aware, like, he's probably not, like, the best healer to have. I think that honor belongs to Nia. It's really wanting me to pick Valdi here. Yeah, we're not losing here. No way. I'm ready. And yeah, reason why I'm running this is because Normal has an unclaimed world record right now. Yeah. And he has Bind too, but... I mean, Bind is kind of trash on some enemies. Because they'll either be very resistant or just completely immune. I'm going to pass in Kamaravi. Looks risky, but we've got this. That, I don't know if that's a good sign. Imagine if that counted against me for dying there. I mean, it technically did, but, like, what if it really counted against you? Like, I'm trying to think of a good example, but I can't think of any. Last ditch effort, extremely important. Mio has is going to get one of, well, Dominion Flower is kind of meh. Like, she's going to get that eventually, but eh. What the, okay, well, what the speedrun does is, Mio is a tank for most of it, believe it or not. And then she does end up switching to Trobador. At, like, the end of the run, specifically. I'm not too familiar with, like, the class setup on normal for everyone, but, there is a difference for the final boss on easy and normal for what class Noah is, so. Wait. What class is Noah for Zed on hard? Is he Trobador? Like, I don't think I've ever asked that. But honestly, I just love seeing the differences in difficulty in the speedruns. Like, for just based off of difficulty. I need both of these, dude. He's Stalker? Really? Okay, that's really surprising. Because Fencer is kind of... it's kind of eh. Can you at least give me another hero? Also, I hate these urchin enemies. They're, like, really tanky for some reason. That's gonna kill me. Do I do this? Why is Rex standing over me? Like he's gonna revive me? No, the thing is, I need another hero because I need to either be revived or just have more damage. But yeah, Seventh Edge is back. So is 100 Shells, believe it or not. And, Violent Streak. I think Executioner is for Gray only. But what art is supposed to be Executioner on, Full Metal Jaguar? Yeah. Like, a lot of these arts from X are back, but there's also a couple arts from 2 that are back as well. I think one of Harold's arts is back, specifically. I don't remember which one it is. But, yeah, one of Harold's arts, I'm pretty sure, is back from 2. Or specials, what if you want to be really specific. Also, maybe I should have done this with Noah, but I think I have cleared this with Uni before a normal. So, I don't think it really matters. Yeah, if I go into Yoren with only 3 people, I'm gonna be a little worried. Yeah, I think I'm a little nervous. Never mind, I'm not as nervous. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought it was. I didn't want to say it, though, because I wasn't sure. I don't know if I get another member before Yoren, but we'll see. Oh, you know, now we can get to that. If I finish this and the time is, like, absolutely trash, do I submit this? Because here's the thing, it's a free world record if I finish. I thought this was a boss because of how big it was. Yeah, you want Senna. Sure. I think a tank is fine. Plus, that makes 4 Kvessi, so that's good. Yeah, I would probably, if I'm really wanting to try, I think I'd just use Noah. Because Noah's stats are balanced. Because the thing about Uni is, Uni has the lowest HP stat out of anyone. Uni also has the lowest attack stat out of anyone. I should have taken that. I didn't think about that. That's fine. Am I gonna have to chain? I hope I... Oh, never mind. I can't even chain. Wait, what? Why am I talking about chaining? We don't need to chain. DLC normal? Okay. Because I think that's what everyone runs, right? The thing is, I've never done a casual playthrough of 2 on normal. It's always been easy difficulty when I played 2. Whimsies. I'll do that. Wow, 8 viewers. That's surprising. I thought we would still have, like, half of that when I checked earlier. I expected to die there. I have a bad feeling that if I don't get Masha, that then it's not worth continuing this run. What should I do if I don't get Masha? Because I really want to do this. I just don't want to be resetting for Masha. Which is really annoying. We need that. And that. Just add 500. Because the thing is, I think I need a healer to pick me up. So if it's not Masha, then who is it? I'm gonna get both of these. I'm aware I could probably change stream title as well, but that's fine. We don't need it to be super specific on what we're doing. Yeah, we'll get that. I'll also get that, because dexterity is a little more important on normal difficulty. What is Uni's dexterity rank, out of curiosity? Oh, so yeah, that's what I meant about the Cadencia thing. Well, avoiding Cadencia. Yeah, I think Tion has the most dexterity, if I recall correctly. It'd be fun if you could do this with Okay. Uni is fourth. Eh. What about Noah? I think Noah's higher, which is annoying, but yeah. I know Senna is last. Uh-oh, shoot. Didn't realize we're on the boss. Okay. Lawrence is probably fifth. I die. Tion, Noah, meet. Dang, I thought that was something. Whatever. I know agility, Mio's first, and then Uni is actually second on agility. Which honestly makes her fine for an agility tank if you want to use her. When should I give up on this, by the way, if I don't get Masha? Or do I give up at all is the question. I don't think I go past 70 if I want to give up. True. I'm trying to think of a good quote to respond to that, but I can't. I just noticed there's also two higher enemy value events. Whoa, holy snot. You bet. That was an interesting reaction. After getting, like, meh heroes, we get Melia. I couldn't turn Melia down there. But yeah, I think regardless of who we pick, we have to pick a healer. The question is, if I don't get Masha, who do I pick? Because Masha might not even show up. And that just means we're sad. Yeah, no DLC seems cursed. In general. Fifi? Okay. Well, here's the question. What if she doesn't appear? Then what do? Like, we need to make, like, a priority list of who to get. Okay, I think, yeah. I do think I might be using a chain at some point. For maybe safety, at least. Oh, what did I shuffle for? We don't have enough. Nia or Valdi seems good. Teach seems meh. Like, oh, dude, I would have just ended stream instantly there if that gave me Masha. Okay, all of those you will get when you are in Chapter 6. At least I think you need to be in Chapter 6 for Machine Assassin. You might need to be in 7. Technically, okay. Yeah, you need to do Side Story Mio, I think. For, well, Trovador at least. And Seraph, technically, too, because Colony Omega is occupied by Y. And Machine Assassin also has a lot of prerequisites. I don't want anything here. I'll just do that. I don't want to guarantee Mobius. In before Mobius appears anyway. Oh yeah, should I use the stories function on Twitter? I'm doing it, I don't care. I know that was like third choice, but when you guys mentioned Nia, I was like, yeah, I think we gotta do it. That seemed cheaper. Oh no, it wasn't cheaper. It was the wrong emblem I was looking at. But yeah, I'm aware we're at like a maybe a slight disadvantage because we don't have Masha, but I think we're still fine. Oh, I'm not getting the game, actually. I'm gonna wait to get it. Because what I usually like to do if it's a game I'm on the fence on getting... Same with Sonic Superstars, by the way. I like to see, like, what other people think of the game. And then I'll get it, because I'm expecting it's not going to be hard to get, because... Hey, look, it's a pretty anticipated game. And it's a Mario game. But if it was, like, this series... I know that's a bad example, but you know what I mean. Then yeah. You are probably missing Peril Wing. Peril Wing is in upper A tier. Yeah, I think you can get to that area with Peril Wing after Side Story Mio. Is D gonna live? Alright, no, D's done. Yeah, if you need, like, the exact location of Peril Wing, one of us could tell you about it. Oh yeah, Dreadworm is a little bit hidden. Yeah, if it helps, you could list off of what super bosses you've killed. And we could direct you to the one you need. Yeah, I'm gonna need to concentrate after 70, because that's when it gets stupid. I didn't get the event one yet, really? I like how I get a whimsy after that happens, because the game doesn't respect my luck. Imagine like a mod where like you get a Mobius encounter on every stage in Gauntlet. Like, how trash would that be? Well, honestly, the Mobius don't seem that bad if you just use Elemental Genesis, but still. Also, yeah, Mobius can't appear in the water, so you're going to be safe if that happens. Or, if you get a water stage. Oh, it's Dreadworm? Okay. Yeah, Dreadworm is honestly fine. For a boss. Like, I think he's maybe... I don't want to say easiest, but he's... probably one of the easiest. I don't know what boss I would say is the easiest of the super bosses. Dreadworm or Levialord, maybe. Seraphina? Ooh, that's a... Seraphina's not bad as well. Unless, well, it's, you know, it's gonna be mean with Rite of Illumination. Oh, shoot. What? Oh, I thought we were done. Thank God that almost murdered it anyway. We're gonna have to fight D again. Thing is, I think he's gonna live, so... I don't know if I bother chaining. Or should I just use my chain? I don't know. The thing is, my time's gonna be trash if I use too many chains. I've done 2 out of 5. Well, I think they're playing through the base game first, if you're referring to them. Nah. Alright. Hopefully D is not a problem here. Okay, good. We'll do that. Nia died instantly. That almost makes me think, like, would Miyabi be good in this? Yeah, that's also what I think I like more about the base game. It's because you have just so much more, like, customability. Even though a lot of people like Future Redeem more, for example, I think I like base game more. Because, well, base game kind of has a lot more content, if you know what I mean. I would rather do the attack first. Get a refund on that. Yeah, same. Like, I don't, like, dislike Future Redeem. It's just, I think I like base game more. Well, for, well, one. And two. Well, the fact that you have, like, Ouroboros is also really cool. Like, Interlink. Because if you played Astral Chain, Interlink is basically, like, a subtle reference to a late-game mechanic in it. Which can be considered a spoiler, depending on what you think, but... Yeah, it becomes available in the last 2 chapters for you to use. Yeah. We need that. I don't know when I should do my first chain. But we need to have a chain for 140, no questions asked. I want to ideally avoid, having to reset. I mean, I'll reset if we're, like, on 82 or something, right? But if we're, like, on 89, that's gonna feel bad. By the way, how many Kvesi do we have? I stopped counting after, Ashura. Is it... Is it like 5 Kvessi? I could have swapped there, but it's fine. We also have 5 attackers, so... I'll just get to that. Stage 80 was fine, of course. Oh yeah, if I do finish this, I will be disabling the face cam for a brief moment for just a screenshot, so. We need that just to extend the duration of launch charge. Yeah, that's a good art. Yeah, I'm a little worried about Yuni's... Well, not health, but yeah, I'm just worried that she will get killed easier. Yeah, let's just get that. I don't know how much my HP is going to be at here, but... Okay. I'll just recover the watch. I don't really care right now. I don't want to guarantee a stupid event. That's really funny. I recover the watch, and then I get watch depletes faster. Oh my god. I mean, you can get that anyway with an empty watch, but still. Uh-oh. Those gun attacks are rapid, by the way. You gotta be really careful. Yeah, I'll do it. I wanted to wait on lowering the boss's HP as long as possible, but yeah. Okay, here I'm swapping. Fine. What's the point in refilling the... That's so weird. I'm getting really weird onesies. I don't like it. Also, yeah, if I do finish this, we will upload it immediately. Problem is, I don't know when it's gonna be verified, but that's fine. Well, I'm gonna want it to be verified sooner rather than later, because, well, it's a world record. Or, might be a world record. I just want to clarify that in case this doesn't finish. What is stage 90? Oh, stage 90 is a water stage. Okay. By the way, we haven't had a single Mobius. And I don't know what to think about that. Yeah, we haven't had a single Mobius. Which, freaks me out a little bit. I'm not counting, like, D, for example, because he's scripted. Because he's a boss. You count the random Mobius via events. Okay, we'll get that. I don't know how good refund chain is. It seems not very useful. Like, when you chain attack, specifically. The thing is, I'm getting it because I'm anticipating we're going to do a chain attack. At some point. I was gonna say something. I'm trying to think, like... But yeah, I gotta make some channel point rewards, I think, before next stream. Which either is Friday or Saturday, one of those 2 days. I'm probably leaning towards Saturday for that, by the way. Would you say it's good if I do, like, a story on Twitch for, like, whether I'm streaming that day? Oh, if I'm totally streaming, because sometimes I'll have those days where, like, eh, I'm not sure if I want to stream, and then I decide at the last second that I want to. Because the story function seems really good. With letting your followers know what you're up to. Because you don't want to look like you have an inactive channel. Like, if you have it streamed for like a week. Right? That's what you want to avoid. Because I think it also is like a good thing for cases like that. To show you're still like there. I'm a little worried about X and Yoren. I don't know who the smarter target to take out is on that stage. First. Is it Yoren? Probably. Even though X can put you to sleep. I thought I was gonna die there. Yeah, we'll get to that. Hey, if we don't get a single Mobius, I'll give someone VIP. How about that? I have this weird hunch that that's gonna be a thing. This will include resets, by the way. Or actually... we'll look at when we reset. If it's on, like, 131, then maybe I don't count it. Also, no idea who I'm gonna give VIP to. Yeah, let's get Yoren. Uh-oh. Okay. I was a little afraid because I only used it as the master art. In before I get a Mobius right here. Oh. Never mind. Can't get a Mobius. I have this weird feeling this will go just fine despite not having Masha. That's annoying, but could be worse. Look at that. I don't want a really bad event to pop up. I think I'd rather just... yeah, I'd rather settle with Whimsies, which can guarantee me events that aren't horrible. Even though this is a bad event, I would rather deal with this than enemy rush. If we get past 110, I'm gonna feel really good. One to release is Saturday, right? Okay. Well, then maybe what if it's just Sunday? Well, I don't know. We'll figure it out. But the thing is, I think some of my viewers, well, are they gonna be? Well, they're gonna be playing it, but they might also be watching like games while they play it. 'Cause I will say, I do sometimes watch like other streamers while I'm playing casually or something. Because it's kind of like, you know, how you like listen to music sometimes, only you're just, well, listening to what they are doing. And then occasionally looking over. Yeah, I'm aware I can probably handle the Mobius, but I don't think I pick it, so. Podcast mode? Yeah, also, hey. If I finish this, by the way, we're getting a world record. Hence the timer. Also, I promised somebody VIP if no Mobius pop up before the end of it. And the thing is, I don't know who I give VIP to. Okay, hopefully this is not going to be problematic here. Oh my God, look how much damage that did. That was scary. Oh yeah, now we're back down to four viewers. Oh, no VIP. Sorry guys, no VIP. Stage 111 to note. You can, of course, redeem instant VIP if you get 100,000 channel points. And if you're already a VIP and you redeem that, should that just be you become mod? How about that? Like, is that a good, like, alternative? If you save up enough points for that? Because there are some people who I would ask to become mod anyway. It's just, I don't know if, like, they'd want to. Not a good idea? Okay. I just need like another expensive channel point reward. Just because, like, if somebody has 100,000, then they're not gonna know what to do with their points. Also, that Mobius didn't last very long. I said if we didn't see a Mobius, right? Yeah. Uni can't handle a little hydro pump. Yeah, the thing is, I can't run predictions, and otherwise my computer just lags like fucking crazy when I open a new tab, and it's just stupid. And the other thing is, with predictions, it's usually like one-sided, so like nobody's gonna bet like on the other side for my channel. It's like really unfortunate how I can't really use predictions because of that. But I feel like I could. Well, I know mods can start predictions, but the thing is, none of my mods are here right now. Not gonna lie, I'm thinking about that. Maybe even for like 500,000. Yeah, I'm even thinking for like 500, or maybe 750,000 would be a good alternative. Yeah. Or I could do like pick at any percent run for me to learn. That would be significantly cheaper, though. Yeah, I kind of like that one. And I would feel, like, forced to do it. I'm aware Future Redeemed is still on the table, but, like, there's so many things I want to do. And stuff like that. There actually should be a category for that. That would be cool. Like, we need more meme category Rotbart percent on the DE category, for example. Also, we're gonna have to fight fake Melly in just a second. Hopefully I don't have to chain for Chris. I saw that happening. Honestly, that's fine. It was either use a chain attack or use the launch charge. That was a weird camera. Anyone else notice how that camera was like kind of weird for a second? It's like not usual compared to like how it sometimes has been. Uh-oh. Also, just a reminder for those that aren't familiar with this mode, there are 140 stages in it, so we are pretty close to the end. Do that. Just to not guarantee a stupid event. Oh, these guys suck. Case in point. Yeah, I gotta do this. Okay, yeah, you can't click chain if you're dead. I just wanted to be sure. This looks like a reset here. Chat, should I reset? Oh my god. Yeah, I gotta reset. Fuck. That wasn't even an enemy rush, was it? Just to clarify. Yeah, that's annoying. Honestly, that's fine, though. We probably needed to reset. Okay, that was an enemy rush. Okay, I feel a little better. But that's still trash that we had to do that. Also, at least it was only stage 123 compared to, like, if it was, I don't know, 128. Because you would lose more time if it was 128. So yeah, you want something like that to happen then. Also, I'm dropping frames. Please bear with me. Oh my god. Okay, looks like that was only 169. Thankfully. Well, we got no choice. And yeah, that's also why I don't want to run the hard mode gauntlet. Because we'd be abusing that a lot. Okay, I'll get that. And plus, the hard mode time would be probably a little pathetic for me if I did finish it. Are you... No, it's fine now. Fuck you, game. If that happens again, I'm probably quitting. Yeah, I think it was a good decision to reset there as well because of, you know... That's so trash, though, how getting the Whimsy Up emblem does not guarantee that you don't get, like, shitty luck like that. Because if that was easy, by the way, I guarantee you we don't have any problems. Yeah. Depends. What debuff are you talking about? Also, is it the Colony Omega fight? I need to get re-toggled on this. I see the Whimsies are being consistent. Okay, yeah, I think he's immune to those. He's... Come on, this is fine. Thank you, see? Good lord. Yeah, see how, like, much different that enemy rush was? You can Origin Blade him, by the way. And you should be fine. In fact, I would recommend Origin Blading Y specifically, especially if you're on a harder difficulty. Because he is extremely tanky. Because he's got physical resistance, and I think that's why he's immune to, like, defense down specifically. I think sub 60 is out the window, by the way. Yeah, I think sub 60 is out the window. Well, it seems like it's out the window now. This is Irma. I need a launch charge back. Thank you, that's perfect. It's Perfect timing. I got double Mobius. God, that is awful. How I just got double Mobius. I want to save the chain, by the way. So yeah, if we're using the chain, it's gonna be on 130 or waiting till 140. I think I don't know, we'll see how this goes. D is likely going to live. I gotta do it. I don't have a choice. Do I have a break user? I do not. Yeah, he activated Sanguine Fire, so that's gonna be unfortunate. That's not gonna be... Oh, never mind. We're good. Yeah. Uni's likely going to kill. With this. If not, she'll get pretty close. Thing is, I need a chain for 140. Otherwise, this is gonna look bad. Am I really gonna have to do the whole chain? Yeah, it looks like I have to do the whole chain, which is ass. Yeah, this makes me nervous for 140. Nice casual 50 mil chain attack, oh my god. I didn't think that would be 50. I don't like this. I really don't like this. That's Irma again. We're outside colony mood. This is really fitting. Yeah, that's a very fitting Mobius for where we're at right now. I mean, it probably didn't matter what I picked there, because we're already above 100k.
choice.
Don't go drop him dead on me now.
I didn't get that, seriously? That's fine. Yeah, I'm a little worried. Especially since the chain attack gauge is, yeah, where it's at right now. I don't know what I... Well, I don't know. If it ends on 140, I might just... This run is in the toilet. Fuck you, G. Nia, pick me up. Yeah, I gotta pop this. This is really fucking annoying. This makes me not want to continue. You really did that at the perfect time, did you? Well, you're reviving me at least. What is Calamity? Oh no. I have never seen that attack before in my life. So he charges like a bull, which is really fucking cool. You're gonna murder me, aren't you? Oh my god. I hope some of you were watching that, because that was fucking amazing. Oh my god, dude. That was like... That was perfect. Yeah, you know what? I'm doing that. Just because where we're at right now is... Like... It's a really delicate situation. I'm not gonna get that one. Is he using Beyond Death? Don't revive me. That's, yeah, I'm done with, I'm not trying that again. That, well, I don't know, G just made that, like, 10 times worse, because I didn't have another launch charge, and I'm just done with it. So it's like, what was I supposed to do? And I'm not gonna go back to 130 and waste my time only for it to just end up the same way. I'm abandoning this, by the way. I'm not gonna try again, because fuck that. Because, yeah, this isn't worth my time. Because that's a third reset. Should I tweet that clip out? That's really fucking stupid that that happened. Well, not the 140 clip, but like, you know. Yeah, you know what? Let's tweet the clip. How many clips do we have? What's this one? What a... Oh, that's the 50 mil. I know exactly what to say for this. Literally, Rex carried that. Fortunately, yeah, that's how a normal mode run died. I keep wanting to go over there because I've been doing time attack.
Let's try not to piddle our money away.
Okay, let's upgrade the accessory I want to upgrade as well, while we're at it. Let me yoink that clip, by the way, from Twitter as well. Put it in the Xenoblade 3 channel. I also didn't know G runs like a fucking bull, which is hilarious. Yeah, it's this one, I think. It's this one. Well, it's not as probably good.
away safely now.
Well, that already looks better. We need to know Noponic gold is the thing. Oh yeah, I'll post it in the... was under... Yeah, I really wanted to claim that, but I don't think I care. To be honest. Yeah, so now here I'm just gonna click easy, because fuck that. No, and also I just clicked Noah. I do want to try and clear with Lucky 7, but... That seems like it'll be tough. Like, what would I even do? I'll just do the first stage. See what I get. Would have gotten. Okay.
I go wherever you go. Let's get conquering, ladies and
gentlemen. That's enough for now. Prince will just have to try again. Try better.
I like how you get one. Because, well, I think you get, like, on... Well, I don't know if you get more on hard for passing the first stage, but yeah.
Lucky challenge! Friends cannot resist, yes?
But yeah, that was, really unfortunate.
This challenge is real.
I didn't want to try again, by the way, because, odds are... If I ran into the same situation I did with G, I would have had the same result. It didn't help that I didn't have a chain attack ready either, because... Yes, that was like the worst possible luck I could have had. You know what? Talked about Issard last time. We'll pick him this time. Okay, this shop's gonna probably be horrible. Never mind. I don't know, I don't have a good feeling that this will be any better. Because I think we had some pretty good emblems for where we were at. It's just the events were very unkind. Yeah, we'll get to that. Oh yeah, I don't know if I try that again for a while, just saying. Because, I mean, I don't know if I try normal again in general for a while, because, yeah. That was dumb. Imagine if you could change the difficulty. Dude, I gave up on it. I died on 140. But you must watch this. I also made a tweet, but it's of this clip, so... So, we had a Mobius interference. I had to use a launch... I think two launch charges. Honestly, I'm gonna give you your points back. Even though I could do it, I'm already in the thing, so... Yeah, I'll just give you your points back, because I'd rather you save them up for the, the New Game Plus level down. How do I... Yeah, save them up for the New Game Plus level down playthrough. Review, okay, requests. And more items. I also have these stupid ones, like, pick my team in Xenoblade, which obviously only applies to all but this game, right? Because you can't really pick a team in this game, if you know what I mean. Alright, these are all just toggle face cam, except that one. I'll just give you your points back. If it was another day, I would have probably done it. Or if I didn't do that. It's just, I'm not ready. To deal with, like, heartbreak, like... That again. Because I was aware something bad was gonna happen, but, like... I didn't think I would be that screwed. It's also why I don't love trying to beat my record in general with this. Are you kidding? I'm very confused. Well, I guess I have a question before I answered it. Have you had either one of those before? Because my answer will depend on whether you've had them before or not. Also, the Ask Me Anything channel point was taken from a friend. Okay. So I'm not gonna think about my answer as much then. Well, if I were you, I would definitely try the Mango Loco Monster. That's what I would do if I was in your boots. Apparently Ethel was sleeping on the job. No problem. Oh, here's a good idea. Maybe for, like, this gauntlet. You guys... would pick the heroes that I would have to pick. Like, via, like, a channel point reward. Would that be interesting? And then I'd have to adapt depending on, like, what heroes get picked. Obviously, like, I'm not gonna add it, like, today, because we're just sort of thinking about the idea. But it seems cool. Yeah. I think Rex deserves to be on the team, considering that he, you know, won that fight for us. Yeah, if that fight was anything to, say, like, then, yeah. Just do that. I already don't like, the shop, what it's been giving us. Damn, why is it whenever I'm not paying attention, like, there's always a conversation in the Xenoblade X server? And when I'm, like, looking at the server, it's quiet as fuck. Nah. Yeah, they're talking about the Switch 2, by the way. Or, Switch, quote, 2. Well, yeah, the thing is, oh, I don't want these right now. Oh, we have 10,000 exactly. But yeah, I'm still processing the disappointment. Yeah, I refunded. Yeah, like if this was if we were doing Gauntlet like the next stream I do it, I would totally do it then. It was like, yeah. Somebody just posted a meme in the X server of, like, it was an NL meme. So, the city in X is called NLA, and then it says versus NLA as the character. Like, oh, that's a dumb meme. Also, it has NL's face, and I don't know if he'd be, like, comfortable. Well, I mean, I don't know. Then again, I post my own face, but... And there's the gif of him opening, like, the Cosmos box on Tenor or whatever. So, like, yeah. It's only if it was, like, really not appropriate where I would consider deleting it. Or if they were talking about him in the, what's it called? in a defaming way. Yeah, that's the term I was looking for. Yeah, I'm just gonna chill, by the way, since, well, that attempt failed. I think I give myself a break until I try again. And the thing is, I don't think I could have continued on based on where I was at. I wish you could disable, like, the autosave. Like, I wish it could ask, do you want your game to save or something? Instead of just saving for you. Because I could have continued from 120. If I wanted. I realize I would lose more time that way. It's just... I had to use a chain attack. I don't know, I just maybe need to practice it in general. Which you could have made the argument that I... don't give up on that attempt. Honestly, I really wanted that to stay in, though, because of the Rex fight. That was just a meme itself. I said Rex fight. Oh.
I'm fully equipped for action.
There's Masha. Okay. Oh yeah, there's a bunch of them. I have an image of it, but like, it's just an image, and it's on my phone, so... let me post this stupid clip in... the, X server. There we go. Who just joined? Oh, you did. Okay, I was like, about to say, we had a situation earlier where I had to kick someone out because they posted an offensive meme, and I wanted to be sure who it was. That, possibly joined. Because, yeah, it's a little inappropriate to discuss what the meme was about, but... it was using, like, a Clash of Clans format... based... and just using, like, an event that's currently happening... in, well... a country, like, none of us are a part of. That's all I'll say. Now, I would have banned them, but they were a user that was, that's been in the server for a while. So, that's why it was just a kick. If it was, like, a brand new user, then yeah, it would have been a ban. Also, yeah, do that as well. I need an attacker. Yeah, at least one attacker. Wait, they both have to be Kvesi. I just realized. So... yeah, that sucks. I'm not gonna send that 50 mil chain attack... to Twitter. It's not worth it. Because that clip with G is already hilarious enough. Because I had one where Shulk finished off, like, an enemy. But no, now I have one where Rex finishes off a Mobius by himself, basically. Which is hilarious. It just shows, like, it That's like a good like clip of showing like Rex is just better than Shulk. In many ways. Speaking of, he just stole the kill from me. Oh yeah, if you want image permissions, get yourself a role in bot channel, by the way.
You will not regret this decision.
I feel like I always have to take Melia. By the way, if she pops up. Eh. Let's get that message, or mark that as red. Yeah, it's pretty basic. Basically, let me just look at my the rules in our server here. Well, minus the Twitch chat thing. And I guess the translation, because it's mostly an English server. And yeah, I added a new rule, actually, to this server. And it was actually for, like, a friend. I don't know if he's going to show up, but this one's pretty... I mean, that's self-explanatory, right? Please avoid bringing outside drama into the server stream. If you have an issue with someone outside the server and are... Because, like, I'm aware people have issues with other people outside the server. They don't feel like you have to leave because of that person. Like, if anything, I would be more than glad to, like, help patch things up with, like, someone. Unless it's just really bad, for example. If that was W, that would have been kind of funny, by the way. But this was V. Oh, that was like one letter next to W, actually. Well, might have as well been W. But yeah, here's another thing I don't like. Well, I don't love sitting on the border of, like, 350 followers. Because if somebody else unfollows, that's just gonna be really annoying. Also, kinda wish somebody clipped that G fight. Because that was just absolutely hilarious. You know? Maybe I could, I don't know if I'd be able to post the story like from like a video, but you can post your own clips and stuff. Thing is, people rarely clip on my stream, and it's kind of annoying. Oh, it's just division roles. I can just give you a generic role, if you want, but yeah. Also, yeah, there is a spoiler channel as well. I'd probably recommend muting it, even though it's not super active. Oh yeah, that's another thing. Bad timing as well. I'm actually gonna get this, because we have Ethel. And I don't like clipping myself because, well, if you clip yourself, what's the point, right? You might as well just have it in, like, a video. Or, like, just highlight it. Because, yeah, clipping yourself means you could just highlight it. At that point. Yeah, we'll get to that. Wow, I'd rather this, honestly. Honestly, like, that whole previous attempt kind of, like, that was an experience, I'm just gonna say. Because, well, 130 was fine, like, whatever. Then we have G who appears, and then it turns into, like, a complete shit show of a fight where I don't even know if I'm going to be able to continue. Because I think maybe even without G, we still would have had a problem. Which is why I didn't think I should try again. I don't think any of the emblems I bought also affected anything as well, so don't really have to worry about it. I'm aware I don't probably need the Elemental Genesis, but it's whatever. Metal pipe falling sound effect left my ass off. Also, yeah, here's another thing I want to discuss, actually. Because sometimes I like talking about, like, what, you know, the server talks about, and it, like, especially if it's not, like, bad. Oh, I thought this was a different emblem. But yeah, somebody wanted me to add an emote of, like, art, by the way. And I feel weird about adding an art emote or like a sticker emote of like art without asking the artist's permission before I do so. And the thing is, I'm not gonna name off who this artist is out of courtesy, but like, I'm not a huge fan of them, to be honest, because like, I don't follow them. But yeah, just like, don't force me to, or don't make me feel forced to add something I don't want to add. Because if you really, well, I don't know if they have Nitro, the person that wanted it to be added, but if they do have Nitro, there's nothing stopping them from adding it on another server. Because, yeah, what I don't want to do is add an emote just for, like, somebody for to use with Nitro. Like, that's like, come on, man. Because there's people without Nitro who want, some good emotes in the server. Yeah, because, like, if it was, like, if it wasn't an art emote, I would have totally considered it. But the fact that, like, one, it's a large server, and two, oh, I mean, if it's a small server, the artist probably wouldn't mind. And plus, if I was a little skeptical on it, I would maybe include, like, the emote of the art and welcome. In fact, in our server here, not in the X server, but I also have, like, art emotes, so, like, I think there's, like, a Union Tion one. Let me just clarify before I say something. That's not the one I was thinking about. Okay, well, there is a tie-on one. Okay, yeah. Some of the... I don't think there is a union tie-on one together. But yeah, there is a... the tie-on smug one. I know who the artist is from that emblem. And they said you can use the... art if you want. So, like... Yeah, that's why I just added them. Now, if any artist says, like, to not use them, or, like, they don't straight up give permission unless you ask them, then I won't use it. Because the thing is, the only reason I use the, well, one, the two images in the, The two images in my overlay is because, well, one was a commission, and two, the other one was technically, like, a gift, so. Yeah, I think a commission is fine to use if, like, you're the one that commissioned it. So. Gee, I don't need you to give me another nightmare like you just did. God. Why did he have to show up again? Also, I don't know if B would have been any better. I hate that G showed up again. That was too soon, man. I would have rather seen B instead of G, because B is probably just as annoying. I don't know if B has, like, a charge move like G did. Because G just rushed at someone like a bull, and it was kind of funny. Because I'd never seen that before. I'd say this attempt is fine, by the way. It's probably not, like, good for, like, the speedrun, you know, but... It can work. Wow, what is with this hitbox? Oh yeah, Uni just says to Ethel, "You're sparking amazing." Which is funny. Who's gonna be server member 150? Because, like, the thing is, like, I don't mind if some people, like, invite others to the server. It's just, I'm a little skeptical of promoting it the server myself, to be honest. I was briefly tempted to do a Caesar-only run in Emerald after stream until I remembered Caesar's Gen 3 learns it sucks and it wouldn't be fun. Yeah. Also, if it's, like, on actual, like, console, it would probably be hard, because you'd have to evolve, I think, a Scyther, right? You can't just catch Caesar straight up until later. Because I really want a Caesar in Black and White, too, but I think I have to transfer it from Heart Gold, Soul Silver, unfortunately. Oh yeah, since you brought up Pokemon, have you ever heard of Ironmon? I've never tried the challenge, of course, because like I haven't like set up like an emulator or anything, but Ironmon is like a really interesting form of a Nuzlocke. And it was created by I Ate Your Pie. I don't know if you've heard of him, but yeah, he's a pretty big streamer. And yeah, there's like three or four different rule sets for Ironmon. There's like standard, ultimate, Kaizo, and survival. Survival has limited Pokemon center healing throughout the run. And that's honestly kind of nuts. And you can't like grind as well, because like that's sort of against the spirit. And it takes out anything like that has arena trap, for example, because it doesn't let you run away. And they support like all games, like up until like Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon as well. I would do a black and white to Ironmon, but it sounds, or not just an Ironmon, but like a rando in general. Ah, okay. Hardest Ironmon is probably Heart Gold Soul Silver because, well, you have to defeat Red. Oh, yeah. And I still haven't defeated Red, by the way, in my copy of Soul Silver. All I have is my Crobat and my sort of underleveled Feraligatr, which is kind of unfortunate. And like, best I could do is probably catch Heatran or something in Platinum. Oh yeah. Think Heatran's a little annoying to catch in Platinum, because it might require you to get like the national dex or something. Because yeah, I never caught Heatran as well as Zelf and Uxie. Fact, I never caught Mesprit in Brilliant Diamond Shining Pearl, because Mesprit's apparently a roamer. I haven't caught Cresselia either, to be fair, but like I have no idea how to deal with roamers specifically, because like they're really hard to like just find. Because what I did with Raikou is I just straight up caught Raikou with the Master Ball. I think Raikou was like better to use the Master Ball on than Lugia, for example, because like Lugia is not gonna flee on you, right? So yeah, just Master Ball Raikou and you're good. Oh yeah, I already sent Raikou to Black and White too as well, so can't really do much without him. I just noticed we're past stage 70 again. Feels like this run's been going on longer than, the previous one, but it's fine, I guess. It's really unfortunate that G had to ruin that run, basically. Even though we won, he just made us severely unprepared for 140. And I don't even think refilling the gauge really helped at all there. Oh, yeah, so Radis, I just had the weirdest ending trying to claim that normal mode world record. And it was thanks to G, like, appearing. Rex basically soloed it. And G apparently charges like a bull, kind of. And it looks kind of funny. I didn't get the clip in here, but it looked cool because I never seen it before. Wait. He picked Nia up. And that counts as a hit. So does that mean... Wow, I got really lucky here. Oh, that missed anyway, but... Yeah. I think that made her go to 1 HP, because I don't think that first hit can kill, specifically. I'm assuming it works the same way on B and Y, so the attack can't, or the first hit can't kill you, but the second hit can. No, I died on 140. I only had one launch charge, and I didn't have a chain attack because I used it on 130. If I had a chain attack, I would have totally used it. Yeah, I think I just needed to reset. Like, start from a new run either way. It was just really unfortunate. Because that was a really funny world record. Or that would have been a really funny world record because of G just being an absolute jerk. And I'm a little sad that that didn't get included. Oh, DJ won. Hard world record. Oh my god. Yeah. Take a look at that. Oh yeah. So this weekend, by the way, I'm planning to start a New Game Plus level down playthrough. And additionally, I'm only gonna be able to control Uni. Or Tion if I do like unit spam or whatever, right? So I think that'll be, like, really interesting. Since I won't be able to properly use Lucky 7. And you would also be able to force me to, change the class on Uni or anyone else to make it interesting. Of course, I would set up, like, the class myself, but yeah. Yeah, unfortunately, my Switch is, not, like, you know, dated, but it's sort of, like, past the date. Also, take care, Omega. Let's turn the face cam back on, by the way. But yeah, I'm gonna take my Switch out, by the way, don't freak out. But... Oh. I forgot it does this. But yeah, my Switch is kind of, like, it came with Smash Ultimate. And I think I needed, like, a Switch before Smash Ultimate came out, specifically. Like, late 2017 or something, and that would have been good. Let's put this back in here. Hopefully it's fine. I don't usually ever take my Switch out in this case. Okay, it seems fine. Check the... Oh, okay. I'll check it after this stage. Yeah, Then Google the ranges of cereals. Okay. Actually, I'll jot the barcode down. Really fast, unless it's something weird. Where is it? Oh! I thought it hit something. Oh, it's on the very bottom. I'm dumb. Okay, I see it. Actually, you know what? I can Google it after. Yeah. I'm just dumb and thought it was like on the back of the Switch itself. You know? Oh yeah, I do mod my Wii U, but I only mod it for Xenoblade X. I don't mod it for like any other game. But I feel like I could. This is the thing, because I do want to try a randomizer of Donkey Kong 64, and I think I'm not the only one who, I think you can do it on Wii U, it's just like, well, I'm a little anxious about trying it. But yeah, actually, you know what? I'll jot it down right now. I know it's a little weird, because like, there's nothing on screen, but yeah. I need to get in a channel to type this. Let's hope I don't mistype it. Oh, there's only three letters? Or the first, three characters are letters, I think, right? And then the rest is just random numbers, from what it seems. What event do I want here? Well, probably the legendary emblems. Ah, okay. Let's do this stage and then I'll Google it. Because if my Switch is hackable, I'm not against it. It's just, well, the thing is I'm nervous because, they probably care more about the Switch than they did the Wii U ever when it was the active console. All right. It's just given me models. Yeah, the thing is I have two docks. My other dock is right there, and that's for playing on the TV. And it's, a better experience than just playing, right now, of course. But, of course I sacrifice, the experience that the TV gives me, you know? Because, that's the only easy way to, get something recorded or streamed. Okay, Switch hackable serial list is probably what I want to look at. Maybe, it's just... The thing is, it's so far away. And I don't know if, there'd be, a ton of cables that would have to go through on the floor, because, to the right here is my bed. And it's sitting, up top of a dresser as well. Oh. Apparently, you'll be okay. This is a weird list that I'm looking at right here. Yeah, I think my Switch is potentially patched. Like, it might not be hackable, but it's not, like, guaranteed to not be hackable. This might not be, like, the right thing to look at either. I'm maybe, like, looking at the complete wrong thing. Interesting. Which Switch models are hackable? Launch model, obviously. Yeah, it's like a maybe is like probably means no. Or maybe means like I have no idea. Because they don't know what they're talking about. Because I don't think a maybe will ever mean yes. It means I don't know or no. But yeah, ideally you want like a launch switch, but I don't know if my yeah, my switch is not marked with a HAC, a one, I think, unless that's something else. Let's see. Oh, that was new. Wait. Okay, it is marked with this. It says m might be hackable. According to like what this is, but which switches are unpatched? Oh, that's what I was just looking at. Oh. I think it says unpatched, but I think maybe it's fine, but I'm not gonna go with like a definite like yes. Because if I'm reading things correctly, it says the serial number that, well, my Switch has is fine. But yeah, this isn't something I'm gonna do like tomorrow or whatever. Like, I'll totally look into this. Because what I want to avoid is, like, getting, like, banned on. Well, because I play Pokemon, for example, and I don't want the game to, like, flag me for, like, hacking my Switch. Ah, okay. Because apparently, what I'm hearing with, like, Pokemon is. They flag you from just for the weirdest of reasons. And not even like if you hack yourself, like if you join like hacked union circles, that counts against you, apparently. It's weird. The primary differences in is use It is using a newer chip. We don't. Okay. Yeah, basically, these things seem like they're all gonna tell me the same thing. Oh, yeah, if I also do. Yep. Also, Pokemon also flag legitimate Pokemon as well, which is just stupid. Because I've had one of my legitimate Pokemon get flagged, and it was a Vivillon from Pokemon Go, It was unable to be traded. And it was stupid. So, like, their blacklist is terrible. Like, certain Pokemon are able to be traded, while certain legitimate Pokemon are also not able to be traded. Like, it's so dumb. But yeah, if I do hack my Switch as well, I'd also look into downloading maybe, like, Smash mods or something, because I always wanted to try out... Oh, I do think... I have a friend who's, like, a really interesting Smash modder. Their name's Katale, and they make, like, Xenoblade Smash mods and stuff as well. Like, I've seen them make Malos over, I think. I don't know what character they put Malos over. But they put Noah over Shulk, because that was obvious. Yeah, well, here's the thing. Technically, my sister has a second Switch, but I don't know how new that one is. And you're able to transfer your data between, like, two Switches, right? And that technically, that Switch belongs to her, so... I can't really, just say, gimme it, you know? Because... it's hers. But, like, I have, like, another idea. Like, maybe if, like, I suddenly got, like, a bunch of subs, like, maybe I'd save up for it, but I think there is something I want to save up for first before that. Oh. Yeah. I also bought X twice as well, because I got it once physically, and then I got it digitally. And then, lo and behold, the eShop got announced it was going to shut down after I bought X digitally, which was really funny. Speaking of, yeah, I bought 3 physically when it came out. Or, I pre-ordered 3 physically. And then after getting into the speedrun... Oh, actually, no, not necessarily just the speedrun, but... I feel like this game probably benefits being played digitally the most. Next to Xenoblade X. Because if you played Xenoblade X physically, just in general, with, like, none of the data packs, obviously you can't download them now. Because the eShop is... done with. It's just the load times are atrocious on physical Xenoblade X. So digital benefits the most with X, and then it's probably this game, I think, that benefits it second best. And then I don't think it really matters for DE or 2 whether you get digital or physical. I wondered why... Well, actually, here's a good thing we should maybe do. I wonder if, like, anybody on the Xenoblade X leaderboards runs physical? Or physical with data packs? Like, if you run the physical version of the game, you're gonna be at, like, a disadvantage compared to somebody who runs the digital version. So I wonder, like, if the leaderboard should have, like, a little, like, flag that reflects physical or digital. Because I know Scarlet and Violet has, like a little flag for, like, whether you're playing Violet or Scarlet, and then digital or physical. I always wondered whether the X leaderboard should have that or not. But the thing is, there aren't many X runs that get submitted, because X is the least popular... Blade game to run. Because we just had a... I know I'm saying this, but we just had a Xenoblade 3 easy DLC run. Like, a new run, actually. Get done, like, what, last week? And... yeah. I honestly see more people wanting to run 3 over X. Just because it's so much more easy to, like, be able to play 3. Because they're on separate systems. But still, nothing's stopping you from running a, or from doing a speed run on emulator, even though, the Xenoblade leaderboards don't allow you to run an emulator. Like, yeah, I think it would be cool, like, if somebody did do that. I'm just now getting that? Are you kidding me? Yeah, my emblem luck has been really bad. I want to... That attack, like, that G did, like, where he was charging forward, like, he was like a football player or something, was really cool. Because it seemed fitting. Oh, wow. Oh my god. Just saw some interesting uni art. But yeah, let me post it in chat since I have this open. I believe this extension's only for maybe Discord. Yeah, apparently that artist only has like 100 followers. Oh, I wanted the middle one. Oh, rip. Oh yeah, I picked value of points. It was either that or Mobius. Well, I like to think it's rigged to be Mobius, like, more than half the time. Because, you know, the game doesn't like you having good luck sometimes. I don't know when I'll do the normal mode New Game Plus run. Like, part of me thinks I should just jump to hard New Game Plus. Because I probably could improve my time easier on hard than on normal, because I've only done 2 hard mode runs. Fully. While normal, I've probably done about 6 or something. Because normal mode New Game Plus isn't bad. It's just... Well, neither is hard, it's just, the thing is, the enemies are just, they get a little dangerous, and then they're just super tanky. Well, we got no choice. And the fact that one of them poses a problem to, like, uni specifically, like, it starts at, like, DJ2 or Chris, where I have to set uni in a tank. Hopefully I don't have to do that anymore, and the strategies I'll plan can be, like, different. Yeah, when I do, like, look at hard, I'm not even gonna, like, do a run. I'll just, like, casually run through and see, like, what I need to change as well. Because obviously, I don't think the run's gonna really change until DJ2. Maybe Y1 could be a little better as well, because Wyatt Colony Omega, kind of a weird fight, not gonna lie.
Well, we got no choice.
But the origin fight is pretty bad, not gonna lie. Also, yeah, N4, that's just a gigantic cluster fest as well. I haven't gotten a Mobius in a while. Not counting the one that's going to pop up. But, yeah, so I didn't see how much health I had there. Oh yeah, I'll target Yorn first. Yorn is probably more annoying than X, right? Even though X can put you to sleep, and I think that bypasses your evasion. But the thing is, I think you can dodge attacks while you're asleep. Right? Or maybe I'm thinking of, Shackle, like, attacker. You can dodge attacks during that for some reason. Because I think you can't dodge attacks during Bind, even though, like, Bind and, like, Shackle attacker has the same animations. Just Shackle attacker just prevents you from, like, moving and stuff. But I think Bind just prevents you from, like, dodging attacks as well. I don't know, it's really weird, because they sort of do the same thing, except Shackle, like, attacker, defender, or whatever, targets a specific role. And I know Y does that for defenders, but H can do it for attackers as well. I don't know what Mobius can shackle healers off the top of my head. But it's definitely not any involved in the main story, otherwise I would have probably seen it by now. Finally getting that. I don't think that's max, right? That was level 4? I hate some of these emblems specifically. They don't feel like they're that useful. They feel like they're more of like a crutch than they are of a like a benefit. Wow, I actually got lucky. I swear, when you like just look at Elemental Genesis in general, you think it's an ether attack, right? Just because of what it is. But no, for some reason, it's a physical attack. Oh, there's the Mobius. I forget what Aura can do specifically. I think she can put you to sleep. Right? Like, all the Mobius do different things compared to, like, each other. Well, excluding, like, Zed, of course, but yeah. It'd be interesting to, like, compare them somewhat. Well, I think B and G and Y, they're basically, like, their moveset is kind of, like, almost the same, excluding, like, a couple attacks or whatever. X seems, like, unique. I wouldn't really count O and P, like, they're their, like, own thing. Yeah, D and J interlink, doesn't that, like, just give D, like, a couple more attacks? Like, he's not, like, super threatening or anything, because I don't think he can use, like, Doom Rain when he's just by himself. He definitely can't use Beyond Death, because that's a DJ2 exclusive move. Oh yeah, I want to say, if you lower their HP with a certain emblem, you can make him use Beyond Death immediately. Just based on where his HP is at. Because I think Beyond Death is like, what, 70-75% trigger for it to be used. Yeah, that's interesting that you can force that. Also, yeah, speaking of, like, the randomizer or whatever. If I do hack my Switch, I would try that as well. Ah, okay. But yeah, if I do hack my Switch, I would definitely try it. And also, like, with, like, the idea of, like, enemy rando, there is this thing you can do in X called model swapping, and you can just put one enemy where, like, another should be. So, like, I could put the final boss of X in place of Gradivus the Headless Emperor, for example. However, it might cause some bugs, like, well, the final boss will bug out, because normally, phase 1 ends at, like, 50-ish percent HP, and then the phase 2, he'll just stop moving. So, you can't really probably do enemy rando with, like, a bunch of, like, you know, bosses. Like, you can't probably put Zed in the field somewhere, because, you know, he's, like, extremely scripted. You could maybe do, like, oh, that's also really funny. You could maybe do, like, D and J randomly in some place. I don't know, like, because you gotta look at specifically, like, what the boss is. Because, yeah, Zed definitely is going to be left alone in terms of enemy rando. I am thinking about trying, like, a stream, like, where I just go completely crazy with model swapping in X. Like, because I was thinking about trying to replace the final boss in X with, like, something else. Lambda's roof has collision in the fight, by the way. Wow. Sort of like how you can stand on, the Phronus after the fight ends. Hey, unrelated question. Do you know when they flip the Phronus back right side up? Oh, you fall off? Oh my god. Can you... You can't launch the Lambda Phronus, can you? If you can, that's gonna look really funny. I just assume you can't maybe launch it because it's something that big. If you tell me you can launch it, I'm gonna get on right now and try it. Okay. I'm assuming Daze works though, because, well, Daze doesn't do anything crazy. Because, yeah, Daze, all it does is just put, like, little stars above your head. What's another fight that could be weird? When it's not in, like, its specific, like, situation. Hey, baby, I don't know if M would be weird. Can you burst it? Maybe. The thing is, all my saves are bad and I'd have to start from the beginning, and it would take me at least an hour to get to Lambda Phronus. Because an hour into New Game Plus, I'm in the tunnel. Approximately. I mean, I'm not saying, like, I don't want to do it, it's just, like, it's gonna be at least an hour before we get there, because I don't have a good save anywhere. Honestly, yeah, that does seem interesting to test, to see if you can burst it.
Well, we got no choice.
Do I want to do it? The thing is, it would just be for getting to that fight and then I'm done. Also, yeah, I was kind of, like, done trying that attempt because, like, or it wasn't an attempt, but, like, I was just delaying the inevitable. Let's get the, points, at least. Yeah, it's not worth it. Just going all the way to, like, chapter 3, and it takes an hour. If I had, like, a save in chapter 2 or 3, maybe I would do it. None of my other saves are good, either. Do I want to practice normal? How about I go to 70 on normal and see how much it gives me, just as a refresher.
I'd say it has cornucopia of challenges in store. Cannot wait to see how friends tackle this one.
Yeah, as for what other enemies might be weird... Well, any enemy that can maybe summon another enemy, I could see maybe potentially being weird, but... Also, maybe not that weird at the same time, because the final boss in X can summon an enemy, and that's what bugs it out, I think, when you try to put it over something else. I thought about it, and nah. Okay, I'm glad I shuffled there. I'm only gonna go to 70, I'm not gonna go... try and clear the whole thing. Do I want Ethel? Rex felt really good. Whatever it ends up on, besides Monica. Besides Monica. Okay, we'll get Ethel.
Ready for duty.
Yeah, that also makes me just want a New Game Plus in general, because wouldn't that remove Monica from the gauntlet here? Which seems like a good idea. But then again, this doesn't stop me from getting somebody like Eno, for example. Actually, hold on. While I'm talking about this... Oh, did I delete that picture? Damn, I think I deleted that picture. So, apparently, yeah, you can't start Side Story Senna, for example, as soon as you enter Origin, because Gondor is not there. It's just weird for whatever reason that you're not able to do so. Don't know what would happen if you entered Origin... while Side Story Senna was in progress, but yeah, it just says required hero is not, like, available or whatever, so it forces you to go to, like, the center defense team fight for it. And I took a screenshot, if I recall, but I think, yeah, I did delete it. And... It makes me wonder, like, what other heroes, like, leave you like that, specifically. Because I don't know if, like, they can be recruited for this mode when they leave you. But this, of course, doesn't stop them from appearing for Zed, in the case of Monica. Yeah, because Fiona leaves, 100%. I know that. Gondor technically leaves twice. Usher on Ascension Quest, okay. Yeah, that would prevent Ashura from appearing. Valdi. Just the thing is, I want to like minimize the amount of heroes that can pop up, but not like have to start over from like the beginning of the game. Yeah, Gondor seems really weird. Because she leaves, like, what, at the M fight? Like, the first thing? It's really confusing. Who else leaves? Does Alexandria help you fight E? I forget. Because I think she technically leaves after, because you have to follow her before you wreck the flame clock. Actually, I have an idea. Do I want to prep the save for, that's annoying, I have to level Mio, Tion, and Senna down, though. Yeah, do I want to prep the save for my next stream?
Yeah, we're not losing here. No way.
The thing is, I think I would make the run start when Mwamba leaves. Yeah, I might prep to save for my next stream. Plus, like, chapter one is, like, short anyway, so I don't mind going into it. Alex never leaves? Okay. Yeah, I think I want to prep for next save. The annoying part... You need to... Okay. Or, by uni, I meant Juniper. Obviously. Do you know what level Mio, Tion, and Senna are supposed to start at in New Game? Because I'm only worried about them. Obviously, for Noah, Uni, and Lons, I can just figure something out. Or is it, like, based on whatever level Noah, Uni, and Lons are? Because, yeah, I have to level them down before I start New Game Plus. Whatever Noah is, okay. I'm probably just going to make them, like, level 8 or something. Because the thing is, like, they have to get past that guard. That solo guard. And I don't want to make it just trash. Yeah, I'll just make them, like, level 8. And then I can fix their levels. Because, yeah, the nice thing about this is I can fix their levels, like, when, they all get together.
I'll heal you right up.
Also, yeah, I'm not gonna use Lucky 7 until, like, I normally get it. So, we're gonna stick with, like, Infinity Blade or something. Okay. So, basically, I'm just gonna play up till Mwamba leaves. I'm not gonna, like, progress into Chapter 1. Because then that's when I can, like, stop at the camp. Because, yeah, I don't think I need my M fight save at this point.
It's good to keep a record.
Yeah, this is my M fight save. Alright, I'll take a look at that. Oh, I almost New Game Plus without leveling their levels down, which would have been annoying. Technically... I was wondering, how do I work this? We could do with some food. Yeah, I'll just make them level 8. I don't know what level Noah, Uni, and Lons normally get to, like, after D is dealt with. Also, I'll worry about the heroes later. I don't know what I'll do about the heroes, in fact. Maybe, like, I have to do their hero quest to use them? That seems like a good idea. Having to do their hero quest to, be able to use them. Or pick them up where they normally would be, unless... Yeah. Yeah. I'm just setting them to 8. And we'll just cruise through the, start because of Mwamba. You know, because... Why do they not let you change Mwamba's level? Like, they should totally let you. It's like a mix, or not a mix, but missed opportunity.
It's good to keep a record.
Okay. I think he leaves, what, after the Ropal or something? Well, either way, I'm playing up to the camp, so... Because, like... Yeah. Now, I don't know how long, this is gonna take. For, like, this playthrough I'm planning. Wait, what happens if you do this? Oh, okay. So, yeah, so, like, basically, I can only play as Uni. Or Tion, specifically, like, with, yeah, so, like, if it's Y Infinite, I'm just gonna be Tion. But, yeah, I'm only allowed to play as Uni, and, like, I have to rely on the AI or whatever. If I die as Uni, I can't tab off to somebody else. And I have to wait for a revive. So it's gonna be, like, very similar to, Xenoblade 1 and 2, in that you have to wait to be revived. And if, like, I was the last healer that died, then I have to let the AI just win or have to reset. Because normally, if you die as whatever character you're playing as, you just tab off to somebody else. But can't really do that in this case. Also, with Chapter 1, here's something I always wondered. How long does it take for the flame clock to empty out? Also, this might be on normal difficulty. I'm just gonna run it on easy until, well, when I would level myself down. That was just an auto attack. I thought that wouldn't kill for some reason. Yeah, I do think I will probably be ending stream once I get to the spot I want to go to. You know what, let's put everybody in their default outfits. Seriously, why did Mwamba level with you? Like, it should have been like Homs Fiora, right? It's just so weird. Also, it's interesting how, the upgraded weapons have, like, a texture for not, like, you know, having the Ouroboros sign on them. Just can't help but notice that. So does Mwamba's, technically, too. Like, his class was going to be like something you could inherit.
Are we the last ones here? Sorry I made you wait.
It's fine. We're used to it.
But yeah, I am probably going to want to try some of that cheesy stuff whenever I try New Game Hard. I think I'll just do it casually, by the way. Like, before I would consider trying the speedrun for it. Because, like, apparently, yeah, you just, what, cheese a Ropal and mysterious enemy or something? And I'd be interested in maybe trying it, even if I am not technically following the speedrun route of it or whatever.
Better give it a good once over.
Is that what I think it is?
Yeah. And when I play on normal as well, like when I do my official normal mode playthrough, people are going to be able to force me to, obviously save your points right now, but you'll be able to force me to, for the next boss fight, play on hard, for example. I must attempt it 3 times before I can level the difficulty back down. So, like, 3,000 is 3 tries, for example, which I think is fine. And watch, somebody does that for Zed, and then I'm in the world of pain.
There's Colony 9.
Always a welcome sight. And I'm not looking forward to that. If I was on easy, you would redeem that twice. And then that would be hard mode. Obviously, I'm not, like, changing the difficulty, because I redeemed it myself. So I'm just showing it off that's a thing. I wondered why the baths, like the bath tent in Colony 4 was open, but it wasn't open here. Oh, dude, you should have seen that meme N4 fight I had. Where, it was the speedrun where everybody was Uni's class in New Game Plus. I had to fight him on hard. And it took like 20 minutes. Let me see if I have the video. Since it's, definitely not on, Twitch anymore for that stream. Oh wow, this was a month ago, actually, when I did this speedrun. Well, let's do that, just so the flame clock doesn't run out. Yeah, that's that N4 fight. Well, it has N3 in it, but somebody redeemed, like, the points before N4 started, so I had to, change the settings. Because if I'm on the boss, I don't have to change the settings, by the way. I think unless I have to restart the fight, because I was being bad, then I would have to change the settings. The same. Yeah, Greg was there, and he, made it miserable for me along with a lot of other people. It was, Interlink was banned twice for 5 minutes. As well as no chain attacks. And I couldn't swap off of Uni as well, which made it really painful. And I don't know how many times N killed all of us, but it was quite a lot. Wait, where is the... I couldn't remember where the thing was. I hate how you have to do one of these and then you never have to do them again. It's kind of annoying, but yeah. Also, something else I want to do is, like, look at, like, the flags as well. Like, what kind of, like... Is it just gonna let me? Yeah, I want to look at, like, the flags like this, like, what they have to say before I, like, officially leave. Because, for example, if you try to enter Keve's castle region, Lanz will... Like, before you beat Ethel, Ravi, or ONP, Lanz will say, like, we're not done here yet.
Is that... Lenny? He looks worried. Let's ask him what's wrong.
Oh yeah, for whatever reason in New Game Plus, on the mysterious enemy fight, like the second phase, you're forced to play as Noah. So if you're like, let's say, Uni, and you start into that fight, then it tabs you to Noah automatically. It's weird. Ah, okay.
Better log this in the terrain data.
The terrain data. Honestly, I don't even know what level I want to level myself down to. Because what I'm also thinking about is turning off Master Arts until, like, I can use them at their respective level. You know what? I'm even gonna take off Infinity Blade. Because Infinity Blade is just kinda nuts. And I'll just use it when I get past K, but then again, if I'm never able to control Noah, it's not gonna feel as, like, meaningful to be able to use it. Because I'm only gonna be able to use Uni or Tion. If it, like, applies to, like, Ouroboros, specifically. Is he still here? Okay, yeah, I was like, he has to leave by now, otherwise, that's weird.
Sweet, let's poke around.
Oh, wow.
It's our Colony 9 gang. Let's take a break.
Should I level myself down now?
Gotta get ready for the operation.
I don't know what level I would level myself down to, is the thing. Wait. Also, yeah, I gotta take into account the classes. Which is annoying. Either way, I'm being forced to play as Noah when it starts with the mysterious enemy foot. I should really take off Shackle Ring. Oh, wow.
We could do with some food. Where to from here?
Oh yeah, you can technically equip heroes now.
You're a lively bunch. It'll be my pleasure.
Oh yeah, they say something different, like... Rex, or not Rex, but Shulk says, allow me to safeguard you and all that you we stand for. If you have, like, a post-game save. Yeah, when did they say something different? Is it, like, right before Zed? Or, like, is your save having to be in Chapter 7. You can break out from DJ 1 down the castle into Cadizians. Wow. Obviously, I'm not using a hero here because it's not intended. Technically, I could use a hero in that fight, but still, I shouldn't use it. Oh, the background lineup's not available yet. Bummer. Is the hero roster available? Oh, it is. Well, let's turn off long hair. That's gonna bug me. Yeah, in my recent speedrun I did, I actually forgot to turn off long hair. And that actually bugged me a little bit.
We could do with some food.
Should I do level 7 or 8? I'm not sure what level I should set them to. Well, I don't think it's gonna matter. Well, I'm gonna set it to normal regardless, but yeah, I don't think it's gonna matter what level I set them to, for the most part. Technically, I could have this be the quick save as well. It's just the thing is, I quick save a lot, so that's why I don't like to use a save as my quick save. Because you can easily lose your quick save compared to any other
all part of the plan,
save, naturally.
I think.
Where to from here?
And autosave is really unfortunate that you can't disable it, because that would be nice if I could just keep that save there. I'm probably gonna want, yeah.
It's good to keep a record.
I'm probably gonna want to have this save, so I think that's fine. Because, yeah, I could use it for a quick save, but I could just as easily lose it. Wait, all the tips become unmarked? Seriously? Okay, you don't get this until later. Wait. Seriously, do all the tips become unmarked? I didn't know that. Oh, that's actually really annoying if you are a little bug-like with OCD about that. Training drills stayed cleared. So it's not like a true new game plus 100% then, if you've already done them. All right. What else? I don't think there's anything else I want to talk about for the most part. Six Tactician Challenge? Oh my god. Not gonna lie. Oh yeah, let's just level everybody back up here first. The next class I was thinking about for, like, New Game Plus, for everybody being in the same class, is Tactician. But I feel like I should do a, I don't know. It's Tactician or Life Sage I was thinking about.
We could do with some food.
Because I really liked that speedrun, specifically. And because it's like a joke speedrun, you could of course screw with me via channel points. That's a cool screenshot.
improvement.
Oh yeah, I'm aware I'm going a little longer, but that's fine. I don't think I had any things I could use, could I? Right, I need a Nipponic gold. How much do they cost specifically?
Let's be off.
I don't think I'll mind going for it. Yeah, maybe I'll just make one Nipponic gold really fast. Obviously, I'm probably doing time attack here because doing gauntlet would take a while. Yeah, even doing like beginner gauntlet takes some time.
What to buy?
It's 600. I don't know. I could do beginner gauntlet, but
so much
I think it's expensive as hell here. Well, not really. It's not really that expensive. I thought it would be higher. Because I never get Nipponic gold from time attack.
Lucky challenge.
Because it almost doesn't seem worth it. Yeah, I just do this twice and then I can get it. I do want to get a better time on this time attack, if possible. I will probably compromise for Soul Hacker though, if I have to. You're gonna die. Oh. Oh yeah, I found that O1P will take zero damage because of August symbol sometimes when they block, which is cool. I was gonna say, if that was a new record before my already submitted run got approved, I would have been a little upset.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
What even is my record on that?
Fight hard, get strong, win valuable prizes.
53-51. I missed my PB by barrel. Wow. I usually never get that. I'm like way off my PB. Huh. Cause it's not like it's like a regular speed run. But wow, that's very interesting. Yeah, I need to maybe put, like, Tion on an attacker roll or something. Nah, it's not gonna work. It's annoying that the smash doesn't go through because they die first. Tell me this kills L. Oh, that's unfortunate. Yeah, Soul Hacker probably seems a little bit easier as well. Especially if you use, like, Protector's Pride or some shenanigans, because there is a Soul Hacker skill that is the equivalent to protect its pride. I believe it might be systematic defense. I don't know if it's the exact skill, but I remember that was a skill I liked. Specifically from Soul Hacker. Alright. I'm not gonna get anything just yet. I thought I only had one coin, but that was the, what's it called I was looking at? It was the, Enigmatter. Are you dying? No. I was earlier when I had my world record get fucking ruined. Well, we would be world record. Specifically. Yeah, I'm pretty sure these values are like predetermined when you make the item. So, like, even if I reloaded, there's nothing I could do to, like, probably make the accessory better unless I make a new one. Because, yeah, these values, pretty sure I'm thinking they would be predetermined. Now I need 2 Nipponic Gold and an Enigmatter. Okay. I'm not gonna get that one though. We'll just leave it at that.
Let's bounce.
It's good to keep a record. It's good to keep a record.
Alright, and my save is good. Okay, so I'm gonna call it here. Next stream is either Friday or Saturday, one of those 2 days. I'll start this run right here. Probably isn't gonna finish, especially if I get screwed with via channel points. But yeah. Do I have... Oh, I do have this set up, and that's kind of unfortunate, but... Yeah, what I was thinking about was I'd have to change their class before every major boss, unless you guys pick, like, for example, Uni... like that. So, like, for example, if... Well, I don't know how this would work if it was, like, a multi-gauntlet fight. Like, if after one fight, another one starts. Maybe I'd abandon the fight. Yeah, I kind of like that idea. Yeah, we'll think about this more, of course, when, before I get to it. But, yeah, it's kind of like... I have to change the class, because, like, I can't use the same class I did previously, even though you'd be able to force me to do so. And it's also, like, confusing, because there's 6 characters, and I have to make sure they're, like, all in, like, unique classes and stuff, because I don't want them to be in the same class. Because I don't want it broken, like, 2 or 3 signifiers. Just... Nah. I mean, even if it's, like, you know... Me as just being a signifier as Uni, so. Anyway. Bye-bye.